if you look at the earlier registered passengers on board Virgin Galactic, for example, they have astronauts in their 80s that are raring to go. So I see great opportunities for older astronauts to get on board Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin and SpaceX in the near future. Certainly one of the greatest honors of my life was getting a chance to fly in space with my boyhood hero, Senator John Glenn. He, you know, he was up on the pinnacle of heroes as a kid. He was the very first to orbit the Earth as an American back in 1962. You know, back when rockets didn't necessarily always behave. You know, there were a lot of failures. In fact, the two launches right before John's flight, as I recall, blew up, and he was on number three. So there were definitely brave men back in those early days. And so it was an incredible thrill to welcome him back to the astronaut ranks and to fly with him on STS-95. He came back at age 77, the oldest astronaut ever. And we're basically studying his adaptation to space and readaptation to Earth's one gravity. You know, going up into space is sort of like an accelerated aging process. When even a younger astronaut goes into space, we have weakening of our muscles and bones and our heart, because it doesn't have to pump against gravity. We aren't resisting the force of gravity to move ourselves around. So it's like your body's going on holiday. And so it's actually a great laboratory for developing countermeasures to the aging process. That was the real reason we wanted to bring John on board, is to compare and contrast an older astronaut's experiences with a younger astronaut population. And he did an amazing job. He was in phenomenal shape and just a wonderful human being to be around. We learned a lot by having him on board with us. One of the things that was really striking is just how well an older person does adapt to space. He was able to perform right lockstep with every other crew member on board, contributed in every facet of the mission. He was actually a subject in 10 different life sciences experiments. I had to draw gallons and gallons of his blood, which he didn't care for very much, but he helped us understand those differences. And one of the things that he did struggle with a little bit coming back to Earth's one gravity, he had issues with getting his balance back. The neurovestibular system was a little slow to recover, not dissimilar to some of our longer duration astronauts when they come back from their missions to the ISS. But certainly nothing that was a showstopper. It was like a dream come true to have someone that I had revered as a kid become not just a crewmate, but a close friend. And you know, as I talk about it all the time. So one of the high points of my career, for sure.